No, I haven't talked to anyone. It's kind of cool. I see Ricky. He lives in Orlando, and I live in Orlando. I see him usually once or twice every off season, and it's usually the other way. I was always telling him that I've been trying to get the Royals a trade for him for the past couple of years, and always thought we'd end up playing together because we live like 5 minutes from each other, but never really ended up playing together. And so it's kind of cool it's going to happen that way. And played with Prince a couple times too. He lives in Orlando also. So
when this all started, did you ever think that you would end up in Milwaukee?
You know what? Going into the draft, I thought Milwaukee was going to be the team to pick me. So that was originally the first place I thought I would start get my career out at. But you don't really have much control about it after that.
Is it good that you're not going to be like the one person that everyone's focused on like it was in Kansas City?
I mean, it doesn't matter what the focus. It's nice because there's a bunch of good players to help do stuff with. And looking forward to watching some of these guys play. I watched Prince do the home run derby, and that was the only time I've really seen him play, and it was really fun to watch. He was my favorite to watch at the home run derby.
Forgive me, you are obviously a star by major league standards, and yet to talk to you very briefly here, you seem very humble, almost a little bit reserved and shy. Could you describe Zack Greinke as a person?
I don't know. I don't really like talking.
So this is fun, huh?
Yeah. And really, I like playing sports where it's a competition no matter what it is, and just trying to beat someone. That's probably my favorite thing to do. And that's it.
What's your conversation been with Melvin since bringing you on board?
Just small talk. Nothing major. I told him that I was, back when they traded for CeCe like 3 years ago, I was hoping it was going to be me because I think they were talking about trading for me then too. And Risky was over here, which was probably him and Goblin were two best buddies in Kansas City, so I thought it'd be real fun to get back together with Risky.
How instrumental was the agent change in getting a deal done, do you think?
I don't think it had anything to do with it. It was just something I was going to do for a long time, and I was under contract, so there's no reason to do it, and just figured now I might as well do it now. It probably didn't play 1% of anything.
Zack, do you feel like this is a World Series team? I mean, do you think that big at this moment?
I'm not really thinking that big because the division's still pretty tough. I'm sure the other teams are good too, but St. Louis and Cincinnati are really good teams, and I don't know, it'll be tough just to get there. And then, so if you're not first place, you got to win the wild card, and that's probably tough too. I don't have much playoff experience, so I don't know how it all works. I'm just hoping to get there first.
Zack, how much did the transition to the National League affect your decision, and how excited are you to get a chance to have the bat in your hands every 5 years?
Yeah, that's a big plus. I've always wanted to be in the National League for that reason, and it's just fun. Got to hit in Atlanta last year, and got to break up a double play at second, so I mean, it's just more fun playing that way.
Zack, you've overcome a great challenge a couple of years ago, and it's very uplifting, that story. Have you found that you've been able to encourage others just by going through what you went through and being successful and coming back to the game you love and you're gifted to do?
I don't know. Some people tell me that every now and then, not too often. I don't know. I don't think about it a whole lot. You just kind of go through it and just... nothing you could do about it.
Couple more?
Make you a stronger person, you think?
You know what? I think it did back before I left baseball and before I got in the medicine, just having to go through every day that definitely made me a stronger person. For once I got on the medicine, it made it a lot easier. But going through the stuff before definitely made me a lot stronger.
With your wife being a former Dallas Cowboy cheerleader, does that mean we can't make it Packer fan, or what's the deal with it?
She doesn't like the Cowboys.
Oh, really? Yeah.
She did then, but now she doesn't for some reason. So I've never been a Green Bay fan, though, so sorry about that.
You gotta convert you.
Yeah, I like Aaron Rodgers for fantasy quarterback, though. But he got drafted too high in our league this year, and then almost worked out a trade for him and Greg Jennings, but it fell through.
So you know about the trade front and how difficult it is to make trades.
Yeah, well, the problem probably in baseball, too, is you always want to get something, but you like what you have, and so it's hard to give up what you have in fantasy football, too.
It's big in this clubhouse. Right.
Thanks for having Melvin over here, right? Right away.